Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic is the sleeping barber problem. So this is your general example. So if you in your real-time environment also you had phases means the sleeping barber problem, the most of the guys you can see these structure, these environment when you're doing, when you went to the haircut. Okay, so the same concept will be working inside the system also. So inside the system also the process has to be wait and it has to be executed in that manner. So that is a that we are talking about here in sleeping barber problem. In a computer system, the sleeping barber problem is a classic inter-process communication. So this sleeping barber problem is an inter-process communication, means inside the operating system, and synchronization problem. And it also the sleeping barber problem is also a synchronization problem between multiple operating system process. Suppose if there are multiple operating systems are there in your system, so there this is one of the sleeping barber problem is a classical problem, which is the synchronization problem between the multiple operating systems. So let's have a look on this, what exactly the sleeping barber problem is. The problem here is I'll just give a brief description about this sleeping barber, what exactly it means. Suppose the customer, this is my salon. Okay, in the salon I'm having the waiting chairs. I'm having the waiting chair so that the customers will enter and sit here. So here the customers are entering. Customer are entering. And here my barber is there. It's no one is there. He is sleeping. Okay. Here his chair means the customer chair is there. And this is a waiting hall chairs. And whenever the work is over, haircut is over, the customer will leave from this side. Customer leaving from this side. So suppose the customer is entering here, if no one is there, he enter into the barber's room. But if the barber is sleeping, because the customers are not there, so he is sleeping. Now the customer, that he wake up the barber and he is doing his haircut. Okay, so meanwhile the other customers are coming and they are used to occupy the chair. Suppose the chairs are all full and here the barber is also doing the haircut for one person, in the chairs are full. Now the customer will leave because there is no chairs. So no one is, it's already full. So he may leave or he may not leave. So this is a wish. So how this is a process, how the internally, the operating system is going to be synchronized. Whenever the multiple processes are coming, if the system is executing one operation, so until how much it has to wait. So that is everything is interrelating. It is following the technique of the sleeping barber problem, means the inter-process communication is following the technique of sleeping barber problem, and it also synchronizes the problem between the multiple operating system process also by using this technique, sleeping barber problem. So let's have a look. Let's take a conditions. One waiting room is there with n chairs. One waiting room is there with n chairs. And one barber room is there. One barber room with one barber chair is there. Okay. Now the barber and the customer. Suppose if there are no customers are there, the barber goes to sleep. Obviously, if there are no customers means the barber, what he will do? He'll just go to the sleep. If the customer enters the shop, if all chairs are occupied, the customer leaves the shop. Okay. Means generally what you will do? You enter into the salon. If all the chairs are filled, you can't wait there. You will go to the next salon. Okay. You leave the chair, shop. Otherwise, he sits in one of the free chair. If anything is free, you will sit in free chair. Otherwise, you will leave that salon. Suppose if the barber is asleep, the customer wakes up the barber. So these are all the different conditions, the barber and the customer. If the barber is busy means, and one chair is free. So let's have these are the let's some conditions, means what the barber will do and what the customer will do. Now, see here, start, I'm explaining with the help of the flow chart. Start, so the barber is sleeping. Here the barber is sleeping, that means no customer is there, so that's why he is sleeping. Suppose whenever the customer is waiting, whenever the customer is coming and it is waiting, customer is there, then he ready to do the haircut, cutting the hair. Suppose so many customers are waiting means, for every customer he is doing the haircut. Suppose no customers are there, So he completed all the customers who are entered into that, and there in the waiting room is also all chairs are free. Whenever all chairs are free, again the customer, the barber will go to sleeping position. When he go to sleeping position, whenever there is no customer, he will go to sleeping position. Okay, and if the persons will coming, then it will he will do the haircut. Okay, he'll do in the sleeping position. Suppose if the no customers are coming means, whenever a closing time is there, he will go to home. So after cutting the hair also with without sleeping also, he will close. Whenever the closing time is there, he will go to home. So there is some conditions. These are all the conditions. So it based on these conditions, the process will be executing. So the barber may be whenever he is sleeping, if the customers are coming means he will do the haircut. Whenever the closing time is there, he will go to home. Suppose if no customers is coming, he can whenever the close time is there, he will go to home. So now write the program to coordinate the action of the barber and the customer. So let's have a look on the program. I am taking some variables, the sleeping barber solution. Okay, so let's take a variables. I am using the shared data. A shared data because here the barber is the only one barber is there, and only one chair is there, who the person who is doing his haircut, he will sit there. So that will be the shared one. Semaphore's customers, let me take starting the customers are 0, and the semaphore's barber is starting. I'm initializing with 0 because he is sleeping and no one is there entered. I'm taking one of the mutex access seat, whatever the variable mutex I'm taking. I'm initializing to 1, and int number of free seats. Let me take there are n seats are there. So starting n seats or everything is the free. N seats are free. Now start the program. While true, I'm dividing my program, the barber solution, for the barber as well as in the view of the customer. In the view of the barber and in the view of the customer. So while true, wait customer means waits for the customer asleep. Wait customer means here the barber, I'm talking about the barber. So the barber is wait for the customer. So he is still waiting for the customer. Okay, no one was coming. So then what he will do? He will sleeping. Customer, if waits for customer and he is sleeping. So the barber is waiting for the customer. And wait mutex. So his access seat. So whenever the wait one is executed, it decrements value to 0. That is mutex to protect the number of available seats. So wait mutex. The wait mutex is also access seats also. Starting it is 1. Okay. So now number of free seats are incremented. Number of free seats are incremented. Incremented means some person is entered into the waiting room. So whenever one person is entered into the waiting room, now the semaphore, now the barber is doing his work. Semaphore post or signals, he is doing his work. So the barber is doing his work means bring customers for haircut. So then he is again taking the semaphore's mutex value. So whenever the barber is releasing the customer, the mutex again it makes to 1. Whenever the person is doing the work, okay, whenever the customer is doing his haircut, the mutex is making it as a 0. So whenever the customer is released from the haircut, means after the completion of the haircut, he will be released. Then again I have to semaphore's mutex 1. Release the mutex on the chair. So barber is cutting hair. So this is everything the operation of the barber. Now let's have a look on the customer. So what the customer will do? The customer while 1, semaphore's wait access seat. Semaphore's the mutex access seat, I am taking it as a 1 starting initially. So if number of free seats is greater than 0. If it is greater than 0, the number of free seats are greater than 0 means I am just decrementing the seats because he wants to sit down. He wants to sit down. So whenever it is greater than 0 is number of free seats is decremented. Whenever it is decremented means the person is sit on the seat. So whenever the person is sit on the seat, So semo post customer means it notifies the barber. The customer enter into the seat. So it is just notifying the barber. So whenever the it notifies the barber, it releases the lock. Semo post access seats. It releases the lock. Now the semaphore's barber wait. Wait in the waiting room if barber is busy. Suppose if the barber is still in busy, the customer has to wait in the waiting room. Because the customer is having haircut, he has to wait in the waiting room. Else release the lock, customer will be leaves. So this is a program for the view of the customers, and that is a program for the view of the barber. So this is about the sleeping barber. Thank you.